Dozens of trucks carrying humanitarian aid reached Gaza, but the United Nations say while the arrival of much-needed supply bring relief, the situation in Gaza remains dire, with millions needing immediate assistance. Fuel is also not included in the aid deliveries, while hospitals continue to face shortages of medicine and other equipment.
The trip to Rafah and his ability to speak very directly and very bluntly about the need for aid to go in, and then the subsequent aid trucks that have been going in, is positive. I think as others have said, it's a drop in the bucket. I mean, I think the number of trucks that usually went into Gaza every day was about 450 or so, and now we're seeing 20 or 30, and we're not seeing any fuel, which is a great concern.
Humanitarian deliveries through Rafah began Saturday after wrangling over inspection procedures and bombardments on the Gaza side of the border left relief materials stranded in Egypt.
The truck crossing Rafah border are a small window of hope, but they are nowhere near enough to meet the rising needs of the people inside Gaza. We cannot afford to wait. We need to deliver life-saving supplies continuously and at a much larger scale.
Hamas militants released two more Israeli hostages. The two elderly women were reportedly freed on humanitarian and health grounds. They arrived at the Rafah crossing Monday evening, where they were immediately transferred to ambulances. The two were freed following the release of an American woman and her daughter last week. All four were among the more than 200 people Hamas took hostage during its October 7 attack on Israel, which killed 1,400 people. Israel's defense minister says his country is preparing thoroughly for their next step as troops amassed on the Gaza border for a planned invasion. Yoav Gallant says their next move will be a multilateral operation in the air, ground, and sea. Israel pounded Gaza with hundreds of airstrikes Monday while soldiers fought Hamas militants in the besieged Palestinian enclave where deaths are soaring. More than 5,000 Palestinians have been killed, including over 2,000 children, in just 2 weeks. The U.S. now reportedly advising caution over Israel's plan to invade Gaza. Now more Filipinos are seeking to go home amid escalating tensions in the Middle East. 60 Filipino migrant workers from Israel have arrived in Manila, while over 100 more seek repatriation. In Gaza, 136 Filipinos are still trapped at the Rafah border crossing, which is the only way out of the besieged enclave. Despite the ongoing violence, not all of them wish to come home.
There is a Filipino nun, and she is chosen to stay with their fellow nuns to continue her humanitarian and religious work in Gaza. Inaasahan po namin na susunod na ang pagbukas ng border para makatawid at makalikas ang ating kababayan sa Egypt. Ngunit hindi namin matiyak pa rin po kung kailan mangyayari ito.
Meanwhile, tensions are also escalating in Lebanon, where over 17,000 Filipinos reside. But so far, only 100 have registered for repatriation. The ongoing conflict in the Middle East has killed 4 Filipinos, while another 2 remain missing. China urging the Philippines to stop creating more tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Maritime tensions between the two countries faced another escalation Sunday after illegal and dangerous maneuvers by Chinese vessels led to the collisions with Philippine ships on a resupply mission to the Ayungin Shoal. But China claims it was the Philippine side that conducted dangerous maneuvers during their latest encounter.
中国外交部和驻菲律宾使馆也已经就菲律宾的
We feel that it is the Philippine side that should really stop provocations. Rinai Reef is the territory of China. The Philippines sent warships to sit on the beach on Rinai Reef, seriously violating Chinese territorial doctrine. China has been extremely patient on the issue of Rinai Reef. But the Philippines ignored China's goodwill and sincerity, reneged on its own commitments, and repeatedly sent vessels into the waters of Rinai Reef, deliberately provoking, spreading false information, and hyping up issues.
The Philippines remains firm China has no business inside the country's maritime territories.
The Chinese vessels did their reckless and illegal acts with full knowledge that their movements can cause a collision. and this time our fears happened. We are relieved and thankful that no Filipino personnel were harmed, but we are concerned by the escalation and provocations by Chinese vessels who have no business being in the West Philippine Sea. The China Coast Guards claim that they were conducting law enforcement activities have no or zero basis whatsoever. Ayungin Shoal is not Hainan Island.
Manila's 2016 arbitral victory already invalidated China's sweeping claims in the South China Sea. Now, Beijing also accusing Washington of supporting what it called Manila's provocations and violations of China's sovereignty. See, the U.S. State Department slammed China for violating international law and intentionally interfering during Sunday's resupply mission off the Philippines. But China claims the U.S. is attacking Beijing's legitimate and lawful actions.
The United States has instigated, supported, and cooperated with the Philippines' infringement and provocation at Rinnai Reef, which seriously violated international law and basic norms governing international relations, seriously damaged China's sovereignty and rights and interests, and seriously endangered regional peace and stability. Countries in the region can see this very clearly. China's determination and will to safeguard its legitimate rights and interests are firm, and the U.S. This plot is doomed to fail.
The Philippines not backing down in its maritime confrontation with China. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. met with his top security officials Monday. He also ordered the Philippine Coast Guard to conduct a probe on the collision.
We will focus on determining the extent of damage or damages done or incurred by the vessels involved. But at this point, it is very, very clear that the two incidents are violations of collision regulations, the very regulation we Coast Guards are expected to enforce. So we find it unfortunate or ironic that a fellow Coast Guard will violate the law where they themselves are supposed to enforce.
Manila slammed Beijing for its blatant disregard of international law. The Philippines also lodged another diplomatic protest against China.
The Chinese government is deliberately obfuscating the truth. This is a serious escalation of the illegal activities conducted by the Chinese government in the West Philippine Sea in complete disregard of any norm or convention of international law.
Ayungin Shoal is part of our exclusive economic zone and continental shelf, and we have sovereign rights and jurisdiction over it.